Lockout Tagout is a safety procedure that ensures machines are properly shut off and unable to be started up again during maintenance or repair work. This prevents the release of hazardous energy that could cause injuries or even fatalities. LOTO involves locking the equipment in the off position and tagging it to indicate that maintenance work is being done. Before we go further into our LOTO discussion, make sure to hit that subscribe button and ring the bell for more safety tips and training videos. Let's clear up a common confusion with the difference between lockout and tagout. Lockout is when you physically place a lock on the machine's power source, ensuring it can't be turned on. Tagout, on the other hand, involves placing a tag on the equipment that warns others not to operate it. While the lock physically prevents the machine from being turned on, the tag serves as a warning. However, tagging alone does not provide the same level of protection as locking. That's why lockout is generally preferred, with tagout as a supplementary measure. There are different types of energy sources that LOTO is designed to secure. These energy sources include electrical energy, which poses risks like shocks and electrocution, mechanical energy from moving parts that could cause injuries, hydraulic and pneumatic energy, which involve pressurized systems that could lead to sudden movements or burst. There is also the chemical energy, where reactive substances need to be controlled to prevent dangerous releases, thermal energy from high-temperature equipment that could cause burns, and gravity energy, which involves the potential danger of falling objects. Now, are all employees required to train for lockout-tagout? Not all employees are required to undergo full lockout-tagout training, but it's essential that everyone in the workplace has some level of awareness. There are three key groups that need lockout-tagout training. The authorized employees who are responsible for implementing LOTO procedures. Affected employees who operate or use the machinery that may be locked out or tagged out. And the other employees who may be present in areas where LOTO is in effect. With lockout-tagout training, all employees understand the lockout-tagout practices, including when and how to apply LOTO procedures correctly. Without proper training, even a small mistake can lead to catastrophic outcomes. So, what should an effective lockout-tagout training program include? Let's break it down into three major components. Understanding hazardous energy sources. Employees need to identify different energy sources such as electrical, mechanical, hydraulic, pneumatic, chemical, and thermal energy that may pose risks. Lockout-tagout procedure. This includes detailed steps on shutting down, isolating, and securing machines, applying locks and tags, and verifying that the equipment is safely locked out. Hands-on practice. Training should offer real-world scenarios where employees can practice lockout-tagout procedures, reinforcing the correct steps and building confidence in their ability to perform LOTO safely. But sometimes, even with the best training, mistakes driven by human error can still happen. Here are some common pitfalls to watch out for in lockout-tagout. Failing to isolate all energy sources or neglecting to verify that energy has been fully de-energized. Using the wrong type of lock or tag, such as a standard padlock not designed for LOTO. Missing, illegible, or improperly placed tags can lead to confusion about the status of the equipment. Failure to identify and isolate all energy sources. Missing even one source can leave the equipment partially energized, posing a serious hazard. Incorrect application of lockout-tagout devices, such as breaker locks, plug lockout, and gate valve locks can render the lockout ineffective. Not providing or participating in regular LOTO training and refresher courses. Failing to include temporary or contract workers in training and safety briefings can lead to gaps in safety practices. Assuming that just because a machine appears to be off, it is safe to work on. Removing locks or tags before all work is completed and all workers are accounted for can result in accidental re-energization, putting workers at risk. Ignoring minor maintenance tasks like lubrication or adjustments may seem harmless, but they still require LOTO if they involve exposure to hazardous energy. Remember these final tips for effective lockout-tagout training. Regularly review and update training. Keep your lockout-tagout training updated with the latest OSHA standards and industry best practices. Encourage a safety-first culture. Promote the importance of safety and encourage workers to speak up if they notice unsafe conditions. Conduct audits. Regular audits help identify areas for improvement and ensure compliance with LOTO procedures. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, give us a thumbs up and don't forget to share it with your team. Stay safe and see you in the next video.